Simple and to the point. Rode Microphones has been such a fun company to cover for prosumer recording gear. I've been using Rode mics and studios for well over a decade, and recently they've been impressing for sprucing up mobile recording. Seriously, the Wireless Go 2, those mics and receivers have almost completely taken over for my videos. Now Rode's bringing that kind of energy and focus to cabled mobile recording with the AI Micro. You're gonna have to pardon, I'm not gonna do a lot of my normal like holding the product up prop handling because I'm literally using this right now to record the audio for this video. It's a simple idea, brilliantly executed. Connecting a pair of lavalier microphones can sometimes be a bit tricky, especially in a market where we can't even count on phones having a headphone jack with a useful mono input. On my old portable recorder, I have one mic line in for mics that use a 3.5 millimeter jack. Traditional audio interfaces with XLR inputs won't always work with lavs that connect over 3.5 millimeter, even if you use some kind of an adapter. But it's one of the most straightforward combinations you'd want to use for fast setup and recording, you know, especially vlogs, podcasts, and interviews. Rode built a mini USB interface around that idea, and it works pretty well. It's a specialized piece of recording tech, but elements are well considered for practical operation. There are two mic inputs, and the hardware detects virtually any TRS or TRRS jacks. You don't need to worry about any adapters. The AI Micro will automatically switch whatever it needs to make sure you're recording. There's a direct monitoring headphone output, which is also nice, not having any lag as you're trying to hear what you're recording. And happily, it's another audio tool that's built to be flexible. Rode includes USB-C, USB-A, and Lightning connectors in the box. Immediately adapt to almost anything you'd want to connect it to. The main concern I have for this, I'd prefer there be some kind of hardware volume and gain control. Now, it's really hard designing a pot or a fader that doesn't have issues with noise and can be reliably adjusted in so small a form factor. I understand why Rode opted not to do that, but it would have been nice here. And then a much smaller secondary concern, this thing is so little and so light that if you use it with a heavier gauged USB cable on your desk, the cable can often pull it right off of your desk because of gravity. Just gonna kind of put that right back down there very carefully. In using the AI Micro, the Rode apps are pretty solid. You know, Rode Central can be used to make level adjustments for the hardware, and those level adjustments are kept while switching to another recording app, so that's helpful. If your recording app has gain control though, it should be able to figure out the AI Micro on its own. If you don't have a favorite recording app, I'd also give Rode Reporter a spin for capturing audio on the go. Rode is doing a much better job of updating their mobile apps, but the Android support can still be a little twitchy because Android. That is starting to improve though. I was happy to see that the Pixel 6 camera also natively recognized that a cabled microphone was connected when I hooked up the AI Micro to my Pixel 6 Pro. Baby steps. So yes, there are going to be some mixed reviews, and in large part, that's been an issue with Android for years now. Your mileage will vary depending on what phone and software you use. You also might have noticed that my input has been changing throughout this video. Rode sent over two different microphones to test out with the AI Micro, the Lavalier Go and the Smart Lav Plus. Lav Go is a TRS connector and Smart Lav Plus is a TRRS connector. We shouldn't be too surprised that similar microphones set up in a similar way, recording the same source at the same time, will probably sound similar, but I did want to show how the AI Micro handled the different inputs in real time. These mics are pretty solid budget options. Some are designed to work directly with phones, some are supposed to be used with other accessories like the Rode Wireless Go 2 receivers and transmitters. I think they're going to sound pretty solid and they're totally going to do the gig when you can stick your mic to your subject. My only criticism with these lavaliers, I don't like the mounts that Rode is including with their lavs. The little alligator clips can be scratchy if they end up against skin, and I don't feel that the little loop that seats the microphone is very secure. To get a solid side-by-side recording here, I'm actually using one of my Audio-Technica magnetic mounts. No matter what lav you use, I would highly recommend checking out some of the other accessories out there for clipping and connecting microphones to your subjects. But I digress. So the question might be, why go wired? If Rode makes some of the best prosumer wireless mics available today. Well, not everyone has $300 to spend on a stereo microphone wireless system. Even some less expensive options will still likely cost over $200 if you want any kind of decent quality and signal stability. And in a simple setup, you might not want to worry about signal interruption or interference. If you're trying to record at an event or in a convention hall, there's a lot of Bluetooth and Wi-Fi flying around, which can interrupt prosumer wireless mics. They'll even interrupt professional grade microphones, depending on all of that frequency voodoo. Now, this whole kit can be a little pricey if you're buying everything from scratch. But if you already have a lav lying around, or if you want to augment a wireless setup, which included some lavs, then picking this up as a travel interface is a cost-effective solution to record on the go. Tiny, discreet, flexible, and broadly compatible with different mics and different computers. I like this a lot as a recording and monitoring solution. Work from home, vlogging, podcasting, live streaming, journalism, or interviewing, good audio tools are critical. They make your life so much easier. I think the best next step for many aspiring producers is getting out of the single tool, one size fits all idea of recording. I bought one nice USB microphone and now I have the good audio. Instead, we should be looking at audio gear like we look at photography gear. Different cameras and different lenses accomplish different tasks better. Similarly, different interfaces, different microphones, accomplish different audio tasks better. It's about a well-rounded collection of tools to make sure you have the right tool for the right job. Seeing players like Rode in the mobile audio space offering numerous purpose-built solutions, yeah, that's a real good look. I will, of course, leave some links down below this video where you can find more information on Rode products, maybe shop some of these bad boys online. As always, thanks so much for watching, for sharing these videos, subscribing to the channel. Greatly appreciate everyone supporting. You know, those of you clicking the links down below, you know, maybe you're buying a little merch, that kind of stuff really does help keep production rolling. Full list, all my affiliates and partnerships on somegadgetguy.com, or you might consider, just maybe, joining the list of names scrolling by on your screen from my Patreon. Patreon.com/somegadgetguy. This list is a collection of the coolest tech pals in the universe. So I hope you'll check them out. Now, you know where you can find me around the rest of the internet at SomeGadgetGuy on the Twitters and the Twitch. Hey, folks, on the Instagrams. And I will catch you all on the next review.